Good morning, everybody. Pleasingly, since last night, we had already reported the two cases yesterday. So one was a 70-year-old woman at the Bell Cafe. And then the second one was, as a precaution, the person who the expert panel was determining whether they were an old case, beginning of a new case, or a false positive. Now, the panel hasn't been able to rule out any of those things. So as an abundance of caution, we are asking the close contact. That was a cast of the man from Castle Hill. Pleasingly, none of his close contacts to date have tested positive. But through an abundance of caution, we are including that in today's numbers. Now, since 8 p.m. last night, we have had one additional case. This is a gentleman in his 50s who attended Myer at Bondi Junction, Westfield. For that reason, we want everybody, obviously, in the eastern suburbs to remain. Dr. Chant will explain the details, but it appears from CCT cameras that it could have been a very fleeting contact between the infectious person and this gentleman in Bondi Junction, Westfield. The other important point we want to make this morning is that health currently is going through all of their venues. They may deem close contact this morning. So please make sure that if you've attended any of those venues, that you look at the health website consistently, so that if health has updated their venue from a casual contact to a close contact, that you immediately isolate for 14 days. In relation to what we're recommending people do in the next few days, we want everybody in Greater Sydney, and for the purposes of this particular outbreak or number of cases, we are excluding, so not including the Central Coast, the Illawarra or Wollongong. So when we say Greater Sydney, we're sticking to the literal geographic definition of Greater Sydney. For the next 5 days, we want it to be compulsory for everybody to wear masks on public transport to make sure that if the virus is circulating, that it doesn't spread on public transport. In relation to people who are currently deemed to be casual contact, so if you attended a venue which is on the health list, we strongly recommend that you don't go away anywhere, because if health updates that to a close contact, you'll have to come back and isolate. So we're strongly recommending that if you are a casual contact, that you not travel in the next little while and make sure you follow the health advice in relation to the venue that you visited. In relation to mask wearing, we're recommending that in all indoor venues in Greater Sydney, and again, that you wear a mask, whether it's a cinema, or whether you're shopping, or whether you're a hospitality frontline worker. Now, it's not compulsory, but we are strongly recommending that, especially if you can't guarantee social distancing, can't guarantee, especially in those places around the eastern suburbs. We know the virus has the potential to have been circulating or circulating in eastern Sydney in particular. So again, we send out a message to say, unless you absolutely have to, our strong preference is that you do not engage in any activity unless you absolutely have to, especially in those eastern suburbs communities, especially in proximity to the venues that have already been identified. We just want everybody, no matter where you live in Sydney, to make sure that you're hand sanitising, you have good social distancing, that you're QR code checking, and thank you to everybody who's been doing that. The venues that we've been involved in have been outstanding, but obviously in a shopping centre like Bondi Junction, people may check in at one venue, but not all the venues. So please make sure that you are constantly looking at the health website for those details and that information. So as we've done in the past, the New South Wales government, based on the expert health advice, has relied on our community to step up and do what we've asked them to do. So we're really making sure that everybody follows this. If you are planning to go to an organised event, those events should proceed. Because all major events, all outdoor events, all events have good COVID safety plans. So we don't want anyone to cancel any events. We don't want anyone to cancel any of those organised ticketed events in particular. Just make sure that whether you're the organiser of the event or you're someone attending, that you stick to those recommendations we've given you and stick to the good COVID safety plans. Those safety plans have worked for us in New South Wales. We don't want people panicking, but at the same time, we want everybody to be on high alert. We want everybody to appreciate that if all of us do the right thing, We're able to get through the next few days without imposing any further requirements on our population. So our intention is that what we have announced today will get us through the next few days unless there's unexpected things that come up. But obviously we're closely monitoring the situation. We want everybody, as they've done in the past, the New South Wales way, to follow our advice, to be sensible, not to cut corners, and to appreciate that when all of us do the right thing, we keep all of us safe and we're able to keep everything open. So Dr. Chant will now give an update on the health situation. And then today we have Superintendent Holland from the New South Wales Police Force to give us an update on
New South Wales Premier Gladys Berejiklian speaking in Sydney there with news that the Sydney COVID outbreak has grown by one case. That is a man in his 50s, believed to have picked it up at Myer in Westfield Bondi Junction. As a result, masks will be mandatory on public transport for the next 5 days, recommended also indoors at shopping centres and places where you can't socially distance. All of those details, as well as new exposure sites, we'll have in the news at 11:30, guys.